Lake Tahoe, famous for its clear, blue water, is one of America's greatest natural treasures. But for decades, its water quality and clarity have been in decline.
There is no question that sedimentation and climate change change Lake Tahoe's water clarity. In 1968, the average clear depth was 102.4 feet. Last year, the number was 68.9 feet. Clarity seems to have stabilized. That's some good news, but we're not in the clear.
You know, I've been here 24 years and I've seen people from all over the world come here to see the water, to see how beautiful the lake is and the clarity of it. And it's important that we keep that clarity, because if we lose that clarity, we're going to lose the people. When we lose the people, we lose all the money that supports us and keeps us alive and surviving.
The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is one of many agencies working to help keep Tahoe blue. By restoring streams in the Tahoe watershed to their natural condition, water going into the lake will carry less sediment, helping maintain Tahoe's prized clarity.
The Blackwood Creek restoration is one of many ecosystem restoration projects we've done in Lake Tahoe. And the Blackwood watershed is the largest tributary in the Lake Tahoe Basin that produces fine sediment. So that results basically in a lot of stream bank erosion in the area, along with a shift also in riparian habitat. We're restoring the creek to its natural condition to provide for ecosystem restoration and aquatic habitats in the area. So we're not only providing for the habitat, but also reestablishing the banks of the channels as well, so that in the long run, the amount of sediment and the water quality that's going into Lake Tahoe will be improved.
Near the lake's south shore, the Corps is also working with local agencies to restore the natural meandering course of Tahoe's largest inflow source, the Upper Truckee River.
Obviously, channels are, if they occur naturally, they have a sinuous shape in which they meander back and forth and move around. When you have a straight channel, which this one was in the past, there is very little habitat for fish. So what we're trying to do is create a more natural channel out here. The more the sediment that gets flushed out into the lake, the more it deteriorates the clarity of the lake. And we're all about trying to increase clarity at the lake. This will develop into a more naturally occurring channel over the course of time.